The very first piece is kind of special to me. It's a piece called Fantasy Sketches. It was composed, it was commissioned by the Auburn High School Band Parents Association when I retired from Auburn High School after being their conductor for 25 years. And they asked a very, very close friend of mine, one of my mentors, to write this piece. And he asked me, what should he write? And I said, you're the composer, write whatever you want to. I just appreciate everybody wanting to do this. And he said, well, let me know. And so I said, I'll let you know in a week. And so I came back to him and I said, hey, look, we've always talked about if it's got wizards, elves, and talking animals in it, I would read it. And that's true. And so he wrote a piece called, the first movie is called Wizards, second movie is called Elves, and the third movie is called Talking Animals. And so I want to just read you kind of what his thought process was on the wizards and the talking animal movement. And this is written in the score, so any band directors want to use, play this. He's got all these comments in the score. Wizards. Wizard, a man who has magical powers, especially in legends and fairy tales. And that was an actual definition of wizards that he got from the dictionary. His thought, to me, a good wizard always seems to have a rather noble character, and I tried to depict that in the first movement. So it's a very noble sounding movement. Talking animals, the third movement, of course he didn't have any definition for talking animals. We can all figure out what a talking animal is. The third movement is a bit rambunctious, much as I suspect a group of such critters might act. It is left up to the player or the listener to determine which musical motive relates to which animal. Hint, these are small animals, no elephants or livestock. Also included are a couple of quotes from other musical works about animals. There's a recurring 5/8 and 7/8 measure throughout the movement. Odd meters is one of Rusty's favorite musical things. Toward the end, the things from the first two movements are brought back for the finale. So I hope you enjoy Dr. Johnny Vinson's Fantasy Sketches, movements 1 and 3. Thank you. This band director is Mr. Holland from Mr. Holland's Opus. Anybody remember that movie? Good movie, good movie. This is the love song from from that movie, but the love song is a song that Mr. Holland, who was this budding composer, but life took over his life and he became a band director instead of a composer. But this is the song he wrote for his son, who was deaf. And so he wrote this song, and the lyrics of this song talks about how sorry he was that he never was able to spend as much time with his son growing up as he wanted to or should have been, because we all know band directing jobs are very, very time consuming. So he didn't spend a lot of time around his son, and this is kind of a love song to his son, Cole, saying that I'm sorry, I do love you, and you know I hope you understand what was going on in the life at that time. So this is Cole's song from Mr. Holland's office. Signature is 5/4 instead of what 4/4 is our normal time signature. It's 5/4. I conduct it in different ways because of the different ways the music tells us to do. In the middle section, there are 5 half notes against 10 quarter notes against 20 eighth notes. And if you know music, you know what I'm talking about. If you don't, just enjoy it. But it's everything to do with 5. So it's kind of a kind of a neat sounding piece. I always like to find a piece that the students really enjoy. I hope they've enjoyed this anyway. So this is the final piece, and again, appreciate everybody here. Appreciate these students, great students. Thank you very much for being here, and hang around, listen to the festival, man. This is Quintology by Gary Zyke. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.